Annotation tu melibatkan apa?
Highlight pen.
Ah, making use of highlighted, making maybe use a colored pen to highlight any important notes that you want to, that you have found in the paragraph. Lagi cara yang lain, kita underline the words or the keywords here. Okay? We color it. We already mentioned coloring, underlining. We can even write notes on the margin, beside the margin. That also is visual. Bukan ada gambar. Tapi your own written notes. Maybe a short summary of what you have read. That is part of being a visual learner. Okay? Use annotation. Alright? Or you can even circle it. Underline, circle it. Kita bulat atau garis kan? That's one example of annotation. And do you do that all the time?
Yeah.
All the time you do it?
All the time, yeah.
Cuma tak tahu yang tu disebut sebagai annotation. Sekarang anda dah bijak kan? Got one big word now in your vocabulary. Annotation, you know, I just annotated my notes. Oh. Why not? No? We get cleverer and cleverer by the day. Not the other way around. InsyaAllah, no. Eh? Okay, yeah, this. Next one, outline notes pula. Apa? Yeah, but they want outline. Outline tu lakaran, garis kasar. So apa dia nota garis kasar? Dia macam cengang. Kita jawab. Ibu kita masih buat ni. In school we'll be doing that. When you do essays, assignment kan. Outline, outline first. Now, what is outline?
Outline.
Cuma dia kata
outline. Nota
dalam bentuk outline. Keywords, ya? We focus on the
keywords.
Keywords lagi?
And phrases.
And phrases, ya? Keywords and phrases. Now, how do we outline the keywords and phrases? How do we do it? Sequence, yes. They are sequentially. Ini kata cantik. Sequentially numbered. They bernombor tapi berurutan. Sequentially numbered. And another one, you can use subsections kan? Maybe subsections as another one. Okay. Ini cara. How you do it. Not why you do it, but what it is. So, for example, you got a topic here. Katakan you got stress. Stress. Waste. Stress. Then what you think will be the keywords or your sections or subsections or the numbering system you would use? Key number one will say, if in the topic or the paragraph you have read, there is a definition, okay? And then 1.1, 1.2, 1.3, maybe. Okay? Just the keywords and the phrases here, and so on. 2.0 courses, okay. The heading, then 2.1, 2.2. You did find it? Outline. Is that? Okay, now, terus dia. Can we jump to number 13? Because it's still about making notes. Yeah? Oh, belum buat lagi kan? Then kita kena U-turn balik. Kita kena ghost time. Okay, number 8. What is skimming? Apa tu skimming? Apa tu skimming? Yang kita tahu skim powdered milk tu tahu ke? Apa skimming? Apa skimming? Di bawah topik ke berapa ni?
Tiga.
Skimming. Salah satu dari teknik membaca. One of the reading techniques. Okay, pertama, skimming tu fast reading ke slow reading?
Fast.
That is one point. It is a fast reading technique. Okay, next one is ceritakan sikit. What do you do when you skim? Okay, what do you do when you skim? And how do you skim? Huh? First point, class reading. Then you got that right. Second point, what you do skimming for? Untuk apa? What's the purpose of skimming? To get a general impression of the text. General impression of the text. What you say? To get the gist of the text. Gist. G-I-S-T. General impression of the text.
General impression
of the text. The point to get the gist of the text. Some must be here. Just giving you another word. Another word. Okay. How do you do it? We read the text in a zigzag. Not thoroughly, not analytically, or not specifically, but generally going zigzag. Get the general impression of the text in a fast reading. Alright, this is basic, what we call information in the skimming. Yes, yeah. Reading paper or, for example, what examples can you give to show that you're skimming? Bila masa kita kata kita skimming? When? Advantages of revising notes. Ini merupakan topik. Topik 4. Okay. Topik 4. So, topik 4 and page number. Page 94, this is revising notes. Okay. Kita dah buat tata nota tu. Dan kita balik rumah, dari masa siswa kita nak revise. Kita nak review the notes that we have redacted during the lecture. Okay, or during the tutorial. So what are the advantages of revising the notes or reviewing the notes after the tutorial? 94 bagi dari 3 kan? They give you 3 or more. Ini more, then there are 5, 6, 7. There are 7. 7 bullet points there for 7 benefits that you get. You give me any 2 that you yourself have experienced when you have dah buat nota lepas tutorial, balik rumah nanti ke dia masih sesuai, selesa, you tengok balik, semak semula my notes. Do you think that is the advantage you got when you review your notes? I don't think you have done it yet. Oops, I'm negative. Sorry. Must think good things all the time. InsyaAllah. So, maybe have you done it that already? Dah buat dah? Baru nak buat kan? Jadi kita nak mula-mula, kita bit tough kan? But make it a habit. InsyaAllah, you'll become a habit and you can condition yourself to continue doing it. Little by little lah. Dikit-dikit lama-lama jadi. Okay. Ini dikit-dikit pun tak mau. Mesti mau ya. Istilah kata mesti dan boleh buat. Okay, so apa dia, what advantage of revising notes? Huh?